Throughout history, inventions have fueled progress, transforming societies and shaping the world as we know it. However, not all stories of innovation have been treated equally. There's a side of history that often goes untold, a side where inventions created by black minds were unfairly stolen, suppressed, or overshadowed by an environment fueled by hatred, racism, and inequality. This wasn't just about stealing ideas. It was an attempt to rewrite history and undermine the incredible contributions of black individuals. The patent system, designed to safeguard the rights of inventors, frequently worked against black creators. Discrimination ran rampant, with many black inventors being denied patents or having their contributions stolen. This unequal treatment further perpetuated the cycle of stolen recognition and opportunities. Moreover, a lack of education due to systemic racism made the journey even tougher for black innovators. Access to resources, funding, and opportunities were often denied or disproportionately limited, stifling the potential for groundbreaking creations to emerge from within the black community. But today, we shed light on these stories, celebrating the resilience and brilliance of black inventors whose creations have shaped our world. This video goes into the heart-rending stories of remarkable black inventors who found themselves caught in the whirlwind of racial prejudice and economic disparity, losing their rightful ownership of inventions that could have transformed their lives and enriched their communities. Join us as we uncover the lives and inventions of these uncelebrated geniuses. Also, as a way of supporting our efforts, hit the like button of the video, share, and subscribe to help the channel grow. Your support means a lot to us. Number 8. The snowmobile. In snowy areas where regular vehicles couldn't easily go, people found practicality in snowmobiles. But the story of these vehicles is more intricate than just rides in the snow. Frederick McKinley Jones, a skilled African-American inventor and engineer, played a pivotal role in their early development. His contributions have often been overshadowed by the actions of others, echoing a pattern where inventions by black creators were unfairly claimed by white individuals due to financial limitations on patenting. Jones fashioned a snowmobile prototype from an airplane's fuselage, fitting it with four skis. To give it power, he attached a motor. However, the design had a flaw: no brakes. To halt, Jones had to press his heels into the snow, showcasing both his innovation and his determination to make it work. The snow machine, as he called it, wasn't just about fun. Jones utilized it to help doctors reach patients across Minnesota's snow-covered fields. This provided him a means to survive during challenging times. Unfortunately, Jones didn't patent his creation. His focus was on survival, and he lacked the financial resources to navigate the patent process. Unfortunately, this vulnerability in the system led to others taking credit for his work. Later on, white inventors like Ray H. Muscat and Joseph Armand Bombardier asserted themselves as snowmobile inventors, claiming recognition that should have been shared with Jones. It's crucial to recognize the larger pattern at play here. During that era, many black inventors faced difficulties in financing patents for their innovations. This injustice meant that their inventions often went unacknowledged or were misattributed to others who had the means to claim them. The case of Frederick McKinley Jones is just one example of this broader trend. Number 7, cotton scraper. Throughout history, the narrative of innovation and invention has often been tainted by racism and greed, as evidenced by the case of Oscar G. Stewart and his exploitation of the ingenious creation of his enslaved blacksmith, Ned. This dark chapter sheds light on the systemic theft of black inventions by white individuals who sought to capitalize on the brilliance of black minds while perpetuating a deeply entrenched system of oppression. The story of Oscar G. Stewart and his attempt to patent the cotton scraper, a groundbreaking invention attributed to Ned, exemplifies the audacity of white slave owners to claim credit for the ingenuity of the very people they subjugated. In a cruel irony, Stewart, a white Mississippi slave owner, attempted to assert his ownership not only over Ned's labor, but also over his intellectual contributions. Stewart's request for a patent was rightfully denied, as he could not substantiate his claim as the true inventor. However, his determination to exploit Ned's creation did not wane. Stewart's subsequent letter to Secretary of Interior Jacob Thompson, in which he asserted that slave owners were entitled to the fruits of both the physical and intellectual labor of their slaves, encapsulates the deeply ingrained mindset of white supremacy and entitlement that underpinned such actions. This assertion was a direct attack to the humanity of black individuals, reducing them to mere tools of production and erasing their creative contributions. The year 1858 marked a turning point, as enslaved black individuals were officially barred from applying for patents, further exacerbating the exploitation they faced. Denied the opportunity to legally claim ownership over their innovations, they became vulnerable to the predatory intentions of their white owners. This not only stifled the potential for black inventors to gain recognition and prosperity, but also cemented their subordinate position in society. Despite numerous rejections, Stewart began manufacturing the creation and reportedly used this testimonial from a fellow plantation owner. "I am glad to know that your implement is the invention of a Negro slave," thus giving the lie to the abolition cry that slavery dwarfs the mind of the Negro. When did a free Negro ever invent anything? This statement reveals the hypocritical nature of their beliefs, attempting to simultaneously justify slavery while appropriating black ingenuity. Albert G. Brown, a former Mississippi governor, recognized the significance of Ned's invention, acknowledging that it surpassed other contemporary designs. Brown's letter to Stewart inadvertently exposed the undeniable brilliance of black minds, even within the confines of slavery. However, this acknowledgement did not translate into equity, compensation, or recognition for the black inventors. Number 6, synchronous multiplex railway telegraph. Granville Taylor Woods, a remarkable African-American inventor often hailed as the Black Edison, left an indelible mark on history with his ingenious creations. Among his notable inventions was the synchronous multiplex railway telegraph, a revolutionary communication system that allowed moving trains to exchange messages with railway stations. This breakthrough was achieved by enveloping a coiled wire beneath the train with a magnetic field, enabling seamless communication. In 1887, Woods secured a patent for his invention. The synchronous multiplex railway telegraph proved exceptionally effective, prompting Woods to establish the Woods Electric Company in Cincinnati, Ohio. This bold step showcased his entrepreneurial spirit as he sought to both market and sell his patents. However, the path to recognition was not without its challenges. Thomas Edison, a renowned white inventor, contested Woods's patent claim, asserting that he had developed a similar telegraph device. Edison aimed to lay claim to the invention, casting a shadow of doubt on Woods's achievement. Undeterred, Woods defended his creation not once, but twice. He demonstrated that no other existing devices could have served as the foundation for his invention, solidifying his rightful ownership of the patent. Woods's victory was not merely about securing a patent, it was a resounding affirmation of black genius and innovation. Through his unwavering efforts, Woods shattered the prevailing narrative and firmly established his place in the annals of invention. Number 5, steam-operated propeller. Benjamin Thornton Montgomery, born into slavery in Virginia, exhibited great skill despite his oppressive circumstances. Sold to Joseph Davis, brother of the future Confederacy president, Montgomery's talents led him to manage the Mississippi plantation and access limited education resources. He became proficient in various disciplines, from surveying land to architectural design, contributing to levee construction and grand buildings. He would eventually take over the entire purchasing and shipping operations of the store. During those days, merchandise was shipped by boat on the rivers connecting counties and states. However, a timely shipment was not guaranteed since the depths of water in different spots throughout the river made navigation difficult. In an effort to expedite the shipment of merchandise, Montgomery invented a propeller that could cut into the water at different angles, thus allowing the boat to navigate more easily through shallow water. Despite its undeniable merit, Montgomery's status as a slave deprived him of patent rights due to a deeply entrenched racial bias. Joseph and Jefferson Davis attempted to claim credit for Montgomery's invention, but their efforts were rebuffed by the Attorney General. The racial prejudice of the era hindered recognition of black brilliance. Even as Jefferson Davis became the president of the Confederate States, discriminatory legislation favored owners over enslaved inventors. Montgomery attempted to patent his invention after regaining his freedom, but was rejected again. It wasn't until the Civil War's conclusion that Montgomery's invention received the acknowledgement it deserved. The racial system of the time, steeped in prejudice, had stolen credit from black innovators like Montgomery. Benjamin Montgomery went on to become one of the wealthiest cotton planters in post-Civil War Mississippi. He owned thousands of acres of land and also founded and ran a market center called Montgomery & Sons that included a store, several warehouses, and a steam-driven cotton gin and press. Number 4. steam engine for ships. Born in the early 1830s into the harsh reality of slavery in Maryland, Benjamin Bordley's path to innovation was marked by his pursuit of knowledge and self-education. Despite the oppressive circumstances, he managed to teach himself how to read and write, a feat made possible by his interaction with his master's children. Benjamin's journey took a significant turn when he found himself at the United States Naval Academy in Maryland. Here, he channeled his innate ingenuity into a groundbreaking invention, the first ever steam engine designed for a ship. This achievement represented a leap forward in maritime technology that would revolutionize naval travel and warfare. However, the discriminatory racial climate of the time cast a shadow over Benjamin's accomplishment. Due to his enslaved status, Benjamin Bordley was unjustly denied the opportunity to secure legal protection for his invention. The racial bias prevalent in society denied him the right to apply for a patent, thus depriving him of the recognition and compensation he rightfully deserved. Faced with this injustice, Benjamin Bordley made a difficult decision. He sold the rights to his invention. The proceeds from this sale served as his means of purchasing freedom for himself and his family. While his genius had the potential to reshape the course of history, Benjamin's personal sacrifice highlights the lengths to which he was willing to go in order to transcend the constraints placed upon him by the deeply entrenched racial prejudice of the time. Number 3, whaling harpoon. In the year 1848, a talented blacksmith named Lewis Temple shaped a remarkable creation in his Walnut Street workshop. His invention held the potential to transform the whaling world, yet fate's shadows hid its true promise from him due to the racial inequality of that era. Temple's invention was a special harpooning tool for whaling, but it was no ordinary harpoon. It took the shape of a fish hook with a unique twist in its head, a pivoting part that held onto the powerful whales more securely. Unlike older harpoons that often slipped free during fierce battles with massive sea creatures, Temple's invention hung on, providing an edge for whalers. Through dedicated trials and experiments, whalers recognized the value of Temple's creation. The improved harpoon proved to be a game changer, preventing the whales from slipping away. This innovation was a lifeline for the brave whalers, making their treacherous job slightly less risky. However, racial barriers of the time kept Temple from protecting his brainchild with a patent. Unbeknownst to him, others took advantage of his situation. Racial bias allowed opportunistic people to copy his design without consequence. Today, there are many resources crediting Lewis Temple with the creation of the whaling harpoon. However, he never earned a cent from the invention throughout his lifetime. The racial bias at the time ensured black people were restricted from getting quality education, and Lewis would not have had the financial means to acquire a patent. Number 2, Boyd Bedstead, born into slavery. In 1802, Henry Boyd's genius would earn him a name as one of the remarkable black inventors of the 19th century. As a skilled carpenter, Henry Boyd earned money to purchase his freedom from his enslaver in Kentucky and migrated to Cincinnati, Ohio in 1826. Although Ohio was a free state, Boyd and other free African Americans still confronted racial barriers. Restrictive laws known as black codes denied African Americans access to public education and other basic civil rights. Black working men were often excluded from skilled professions such as carpentry. In the 1830s, after first saving enough money to purchase the freedom of his enslaved brother and sister back in Kentucky, Henry Boyd established his own furniture shop in Cincinnati, Ohio. He specialized in the manufacture of bedsteads, which were advertised as quick and easy to assemble, sturdy, and vermin-proof. Boyd's patented design employed an innovative technology, double-threaded rails that screwed into the bedposts, strengthening the frame and making the beds relatively easy to assemble and ideal for travel. Fearing that his skin color would lead to patent denial, he reluctantly partnered with the white craftsman, losing the full merit of his invention so that he could have a means of livelihood. This alliance allowed the craftsman to patent the Boyd bedstead. Boosted by testimonials from leading citizens, Boyd was soon shipping his famous patent bedsteads to customers throughout the South and West. To meet the growing demand, Boyd introduced steam-powered machinery that enabled his factory to produce over 1,000 bedsteads a year by the mid-1840s. Abolitionists celebrated Boyd's achievements and held him up as a model of black ingenuity and enterprise. But his success also sparked resentment from working-class whites and those supportive of the slavery system. Although Boyd sought to reduce racial tensions by employing both white and black workers, his factory was repeatedly targeted by arsonists. He rebuilt twice, but after the factory burned a third time in 1863, he was unable to obtain fire insurance and had to close his furniture business. Boyd continued to work as a carpenter until his death in 1886. Boyd's story illustrates the harsh impact of the racial system, suppressing black innovation. Prejudices of the time let others exploit his invention, robbing him of due recognition. Despite these challenges, Boyd's creation thrived and became a symbol of excellence. Historian Carter G. Woodson, in The Miseducation of the Negro, highlighted Boyd's success, sharing his inspiring journey. Despite adversity, Boyd established a successful business employing black and white workers, showcasing his enduring determination. Number one, clothes wringer. In 1888, a remarkable woman named Ellen Eglin introduced a revolutionary device that would change how we handled our laundry. Her ingenious creation was a special type of clothes wringer, a contraption designed to wring out the excess water from freshly washed clothes. Imagine this, two wooden rollers attached to a crank where wet clothes were fed between them. With a simple turn of the crank, an incredible amount of water was squeezed out of the fabric, making the drying process much quicker and easier. This invention was a game changer, yet Ellen Eglin's story is a poignant reminder of how racial discrimination could cast a shadow over even the brightest innovations. Ellen Eglin's clothes wringer was more than just a machine. It was a symbol of creativity and problem solving. It allowed people to spend less time waiting for their clothes to dry and more time getting on with their lives. Imagine the convenience and relief it brought to households all around. But as much as this invention held the promise of success, Ellen Eglin faced a harsh reality. She was black in a time when racial discrimination was at its cruelest peak. Back in those days, opportunities for black inventors were often stifled by the deeply unjust and unequal treatment they faced. Ellen's brilliant mind and hard work resulted in an invention that was set to revolutionize laundry. Yet the societal norms of the time would not allow her to reap the reward she deserved. Imagine pouring your heart and soul into an innovation that could change the world, only to be met with closed doors and limited options. Facing a world marked by racial prejudice, Ellen Eglin had to make a tough choice. She sadly chose to sell her invention's rights. But what's even more upsetting is that she had to let go of her creation for just $18. Imagine the sadness of seeing something you made with so much effort slip away for such a small amount. This shows how black inventors had it tough. They not only didn't get the credit they should have, but they also had to give up their great ideas for almost nothing. She stated in an April 1890 issue of Woman Inventor, "I am black, and if it was known that a Negro woman patented the invention, white ladies would not buy the wringer. I was afraid to be known because of my color, and having it introduced into the market, that is the only reason." Beyond the $18 payment, Elgin did not profit from the sales of the clothes wringer. She continued to work as a government worker throughout her lifetime. If not for Elgin's statements in Woman Inventor, the first publication devoted entirely to women inventors, she may have been completely unknown. The tragedy of Ellen Eglin's story goes beyond the loss of financial success. It highlights how systemic racism robbed talented individuals of the acknowledgement and appreciation they rightfully deserved. While her clothes wringer design continued to gain popularity, Ellen Eglin's name remained shrouded in obscurity. The world marveled at the convenience and efficiency of her invention, yet the genius behind it went largely unnoticed. But there's another layer to this story that's equally important. Ellen Eglin's wringer went on to inspire the design of mops that we still use today. It's a testament to her creative thinking that her innovation had a lasting impact on household chores. However, the fact that this influence is often forgotten or overshadowed further underscores the injustice she faced. In recognizing the history of black inventions and the complex circumstances surrounding them, it becomes clear that the ingenuity of black inventors has often been overlooked or unjustly claimed by others. The impact of racism and systemic bias cannot be denied. It led to a disheartening cycle where white individuals used their advantage in the system to appropriate inventions and accrue profits that rightfully belonged to black inventors. Black inventors found themselves facing not only challenges in realizing the full potential of their creations, but also the harsh reality of being coerced into partnerships or accepting meager compensation for their brilliant innovations. This not only deprived them of the recognition they deserved, but also perpetuated the cycle of inequality. Looking ahead, it's important to continue raising awareness about the untold stories of black inventors and rectify the historical injustices they faced. By doing so, we can promote a more inclusive understanding of innovation, where credit is rightly attributed and the legacy of black inventors can shine brightly. This brings us to the end of this video. Tell us what you think in the comment section, as we are always interested in your thoughts. As always, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel, and share our videos to let more people know the truth about blacks and to hear their own part of the narratives. Thanks for watching.